chairperson of the program, respected leaders, honorable guests from different countries, dear comrades, ladies and gentlemen present here today in this August gathering of organized by Nepal Professional Society. Namaste and a very good afternoon. Firstly, let me take this opportunity to welcome our guests from the United States, Australia and New Zealand in this ancient city of the world. It gives me immense pleasure to be a part of this important gathering from different walks of life where we are sharing our ideas, experiences and exchanging our views on Cuban revolution and on the great achievements and experiences collected in glorious 60 years of Cuban revolution. After 60 years, we find the message of Che Guevara and the voice of Fidel Castro reverberating more and more powerfully day by day, especially in different corners of Asia, Africa, and Latin America. Today, we have gathered here to extend our strong solidarity with Cuba, Cuban people, and Cuban revolution on behalf of the working class people and anti-imperialist people residing on the lap of the Himalayas and conveying message of peace from the land of Gautam Buddha. We can see and experience that the movement of solidarity with Cuba is gaining strength and momentum day by day in spite of the US hegemony in the world. We do hope that it would intensify to safeguard Cuba's sovereignty and Cuban socialism. We strongly believe that Cuba and revolutionary Cuban people will gain final victory of defeating imperialism for ever paving broad way toward peace and prosperity. We hope hundreds of thousands of people around the world will ever vehemently stand by Cuba and Cuban people for this great cause. We would like to reiterate that the clear blockade against Cuba, hostile behavior towards Cuban people and conspiracy against socialist system must be given an end and the Guantanamo Bay must be returned to Cuba, ensuring everlasting peace in Caribbean countries and Latin America. Needless to say, a country that denies the existence of small sovereign countries, that denies their right to free trade and denies their freedom of political exercise in an enemy of just and justice and peace-loving people of the entire world. Hence, we ask the U.S. Trump administration to stop its economic war against Cuba, economic war against DPR of Korea, interventions in Venezuela, invasion in Syria and other war-provoking activities being carried out in different parts of the world. Today, the US imperialism is conspiring to create war in Asia and is threatening and dividing peoples of Asia like it is being done in other parts of the globe. The Indo-Pacific policy of the US is the latest version of the imperialist conspiracy in Asia. The US is provoking India and other countries to act against China and is trying to make Nepal a new military base to attack upon China. Ironically, the present government of Nepal that pretends to be communist is acting in favor of the US imperialism and is step by step surrendering before imperialist forces and Indian expansionism. Unexpectedly, once believed to be communist party is being exposed rapidly these days. People have realized the fact that their words and deeds differ a lot. Surprisingly, people have come to know that the ruling party NCP and its leader locked the name communist just to win elections by taking those people's vote who really sympathized communist. The so-called Communist Party is in real sense acting like the bourgeois party, the Nepali Congress. It's worth mentioning that Nepal Workers and Peasants Party, around 3 decades before examining principle and practice, declared the present NCP as a younger brother of Nepali Congress. It has proved to be very much true today. In the beginning, NWPP criticized and continued ideological struggle against the earlier CPN UML and CPM Maoist to keep the Nepalese left forces intact. But the ideological deviation could not be stopped. The derailing process continued in spite of severe criticism by NWPP. The CP and Maoists turned out to be Trojan horse of Indian monopoly capital, and today together they have formed CPM. Nepalese people feel that only a new horse has been introduced by Indian expansionism after the Nepali Congress got old and weak and could not satisfy as before. So Nepalese left movement is undergoing new crisis at present. We feel a new responsibility has been soldered upon us to intensify Nepalese left movement, to defend the sovereignty and to fight more vigorously against expansionism and imperialism. NWPP is learning more the experience of different political parties in the world, combating against imperialism and marching for socialism. NWPP is educating and organizing the working class people of Nepal through various means and is active in the Himalayas, in the mountains and in the plains south. NWPP has been playing a role of strong opposition party in the federal parliament and also in the state parliament. NWPP has been selflessly serving grassroots labor people through the local bodies. Our ideological struggle will continue with until and unless the ruling party do not stop betraying people and the country in the name of communist. Until they stop defaming communist movement and until they serve the Indian monopoly capital and Indian ruling class instead of Nepal and Nepalese people. Lastly, I would like to express my gratitude towards the organizing committee for creating a platform to share our views on important national and international issues. I firmly believe our timely interactions and exchanges will surely make our anti-imperialist struggle stronger and wider. Thank you very much.